Welcome everyone to a really short Star Wars The Old Republic video, and I just wanted to update you guys on some really important information regarding the game, and it's going to be two things. First, we're going to talk quickly about the cartel market, some new sales we've seen, and then secondly, we're going to talk about the upcoming server merges. I'll try to keep it as short and sweet as possible. So we'll start with the cartel market. So as you guys might have seen here, it's Monday today, and we've seen the cartel market update with some pretty awesome sales. Now this is interesting because normally the cartel market will only update on a Tuesday, and those sales will last the entire week until the next Tuesday, or we'll see some kind of special sales come on the cartel market on Friday, and usually those sales will be only for the weekend. But today we've had some new sales hit, and it's Monday, so I'm not sure exactly how long these sales are going to be up here for. It could very well be just kind of a one-day thing, so just Monday these sales are here, and then Tuesday they're gone, or they could be here for the next week. I'm honestly not sure, and that's going to kind of decide how relevant this video is going into the future. But for in any case, for any of you guys watching this, you know, right when I upload it, you will see these sales on the cartel market, and they're actually pretty decent. The first one you see here is the Charge, or the Unstable Peacemaker's lightsaber. Now it's up there for the really high price of 5,700 cartel coins. That is because it is a platinum item, and it's easily one of the nicest lightsabers in the game. I think you won't find deals for it now under 100, 150 million on the GTN anymore. It used to be common. I do believe all the cartel packs that dropped this are now off the cartel market. So they're basically unobtainable in the game right now. So if you ever wanted one and you've just kind of been waiting, now is your chance to get it. You do not want to miss out on this direct sale. I know like a few people on Reddit were lamenting on the fact that they missed a Defiant Vented Saber, and now that saber is also kind of unobtainable in the game. So this is your one chance to kind of get it. It is going to cost you like upwards of 50 bucks. So it's very expensive for just one in-game item. But in my personal opinion, if you were ever going to spend money on an in-game item, this is the one to get. It is the nicest saber in the game for me. It's got the nicest effect, it's got a really decent looking hilt, and it's got that cool little vented thing coming out of the bottom. So all in all, really awesome. If you ever wanted one, now is your chance. Whether you should kind of spend cartel coins on it to sell it for credits, I'm not entirely sure. I do believe going into the future we'll see some better conversions of cartel coins to credits, because keep in mind, if you do want to sell this on the GTN, you're kind of trying to sell it to a very limited population base. Not many people are willing to spend, you know, insane amounts of credits on just one item. So you know, be careful about that, but if you did want it just for yourself, I would say go ahead and get it. Now, there are two other sales I want to quickly highlight. One of the things you'll see here is we have the return of the Galactic Legends pack. Now, this is kind of a pack that drops an armor set. You have a 10% chance of getting the Revanite Champion armor set, which is gold and pretty rare, and then it costs 750 cartel coins. Now, guys, I have tested this cartel pack. It is one of the worst cartel packs to ever open in the game. It is completely overpriced. It has very low RNG rates. And majority of the armors that you get out of it are usually just silver crap that you can get off the GTN for under a million credits. So it is not by any means worth buying. It also doesn't sell too well just as a cartel pack on the GTN. So I would stay away from that sale. It has never worked out for me. I highly doubt it's going to work out for you as well. Now, one of the armor sets that drops out of that Galactic Legends pack is actually just put up as a direct sale. This is Darth Malak's armor set. Darth Malak, you know, is an iconic SWTOR character from the KOTOR games, and his armor set in general looks really nice. It's kind of, you know, kind of sticking to the design of what we saw in the old KOTOR 1 and KOTOR 2. However, I would not recommend buying it. In my experience, his armor set has not sold too well on the GTN, even though it's rare. You know, not many people are crazy about it. And it's also for like 1,600 cartel coins. You're going to find better deals in the future. One of the better deals, for example, last week was the Primeval Stalker's armor set, which was actually up for cheaper than this one. It was up for 1,400 cartel coins. And that was just kind of an infinitely better armor set to buy. It sold a lot better on the GTN. So I would say stay away from this direct sale. You know, you're probably going to find better armor sets to buy and sell in the future. And then the other one, the final sale that I want to highlight here, which is absolutely phenomenal, is the Revan Heirs title. Now, this one is up for 10 cartel coins, basically means Bioware is giving it away for free, because, you know, everyone has usually 10 cartel coins just left over from their monthly subscriber, or even their security key, 100 cartel coins. And so this is kind of like just giving it away to people. One thing to note is this is sellable on the GTN, and it does sell for like 4 to 5 million credits. It is a pretty rare title, but obviously expect the prices to drop tremendously low now that this is a direct sale, because once again, everyone usually has 10 cartel coins or another. I can imagine like tons of people are going to buy this and put it up on the GTN. Now, you can do that as well if you want to, kind of just to get some quick credits. Keep in mind, guys, if you sell, like one of the better cartel coins to credit conversion rates is one cartel coin for 30,000 credits. That has always been like the most cartel coin to credit conversions you can possibly get. Now, if you want to use that conversion rate for the Revan's Heir title, if you sold this title on the GTN for 300,000 credits, 300,000 credits. And right now, guys, it's on the GTN for 4 to 5 million. So if you sold it for like way less than that, you would be getting that conversion rate, meaning you know, it would be entirely worth it. But once again, do expect the prices to drop tremendously. One thing I would say is if you have the patience, buy and hold on to these guys. Hold on to them, because I'm sure Revan Heir was a title that was given a long time ago also, basically for free. But since over time it got a lot more rare, now people are able to sell it for millions of credits. So if you're willing to wait a few months, maybe like 6, 7, 8 months, who knows how long it's going to take for the prices to get decent again on the GTN. But you know, if you know you're going to play the game for that long, you're willing to wait, I would say stock up on these. It's extremely cheap. You can buy 100 of these for 1,000 cartel coins. That's kind of how cheap it is. And BioWare has done these in the past, these types of sales. One example is they sold this kind of blue mount that was really cool. I forget its name, I'll search it up, but they put it up on the cartel market for one cartel coin. Basically means, once again, they were just giving it away for free. And that was also sellable on the GTN. And obviously it didn't sell for anything when the sale was happening, but now if you check the GTN, that mount is no longer available, and so it's selling for millions of credits. Or it might not even be on a GTN, it's that rare. And so, this is definitely something you're going to want to look into. I would say, just as a rule of thumb, buy up like 10, maybe 15 or 20, and just throw them in your cargo bays. Don't even look at them. Come back to them a few months later and see what they're selling for on the GTN. Anyways, I do hope you guys enjoyed that update on the cartel market. We'll move on quickly to some server merges. So if you guys don't know, the back end maintenance is happening on Tuesday. And what that means is they are going to be now disabling character transfers. So all the way until the server merges are implemented on like November 8th, we will not have access to character transfers. So if you ever want to do any last second character transfers, make sure you do them today. One other thing is, guys, they have confirmed basically that the character transfers will be going up in price. Right now they cost 90 cartel coins. After the, when the server merges happen, basically after tomorrow, they will cost 900 cartel coins per character. So it's basically going to be really, really expensive if you want to transfer like a ton of characters to a different server. So choose your home servers now. Keep in mind, guys, what the servers are going to become after server merges. So if you want to be on the whatever the Satil Shan or the Starforge or the Darth Malgus, make sure you guys choose your home servers now, because it's going to be really expensive to transfer after tomorrow. So you have one day to do this. I was also caught really off guard. I did not know the server transfers were going up in price. I only found that out today. I saw the message on Reddit, then I ran over to the dev tracker and wanted to confirm, and I missed that whole part where they said the transfers are going back up in price. So for anyone else who also missed it, today is your chance to rectify any mistakes. Make sure you're on the home server you want to be on, because if you have like 10 characters, that's 9,000 cartel coins that it's going to cost to transfer them to a different server. I personally, right now, I'm going to be staying on the what's going to become the Satil Shan server, which is basically Harbinger. I'm just staying there for now. If Starforge or Darth Malgus or whatever turns out to be kind of the new hot server that everyone's going on, I might have to consider switching over a few characters. But once again, since I have like tons of free cartel coins, it's not the biggest deal for me. It's going to be a big deal for someone that doesn't have that and it isn't willing to pay, you know, 20, 30 bucks to transfer their characters over. So make sure you guys do that now. Anyways, I hope you guys enjoyed the video. Hope you guys enjoyed the quick updates. Let me know what you guys think in the comment section. Since this is kind of a quick thing, like we only have until tomorrow, we don't really know what's coming. I'll try to answer your questions as quick as possible. Anyways, hope you guys enjoyed the video, and I'll see you guys in the next one.